You know, the painful part of this Sarafina story is because the day they were picking her up from the copper belt, Sarafina's child was sick, very sick, and the police didn't have sympathy. They picked her up, and that child is very sick as we are talking right now. But we are not saying that she must not be picked, and she must not be arrested, and she must not be detained. That's not what anyone is saying. When you commit a crime, you must answer to your crime. But there is a law in Zambia. When you arrest someone, that person must not be in custody for more than 48 hours. But you have arrested this lady. This lady is no longer eating in the cell. This lady is now constipated. You can see that her tummy is swelling. Many people think that she's pregnant. Her tummy is swelling. Her baby is dying there in the copper belt. And you are still keeping this lady. What happened to the law? No one is saying what she did is good. What we are saying is, even the greatest criminal deserves justice. Why not give her a police bond and let her go and take care of her child? Why not take her to court if you don't want to give her a bond? What crime did she commit, and who did she commit the crime against? Who is Mutale Mwanza, by the way? Who the hell is Mutale Mwanza to be controlling Zambian police? And when we talk, people say, how does this concern the president of Zambia? How does this concern Edgar Lungu? It concerns Edgar Lungu because Edgar Lungu has allowed the police service of Zambia to be controlled, to be run by prostitutes, slave queens, and cadres. People who are sleeping with the bosses, people who are sleeping with people in the government and controlling the police service like it's their kitchen. If not, how can Mutale Mwanza just wake up and pick up Sarafina, and Sarafina is dying in prison and nobody's doing anything? Who is she? Eh? Has she not committed crime against people before? She spoke something against Manakatwe and Manakatwe forgave. What is special about Mutale Mwanza? Are you guys this dull that you cannot see anything? This is where it affects the president. If there was a strong president, if Edgar Lungu was really, really serious, such a thing cannot happen to his own daughter, a citizen of Zambia, allowing her to languish in prison for insulting Mutale Mwanza. Who is Mutale Mwanza to be insulted? Who is she? Eh? Hmm? Police service of Zambia is being controlled by through woman's vagina. Woman with their private path. That is how the government is being controlled. They give orders to police and tell police what to do because they are sleeping with the police. And we are looking at it. And there are some other foolish people who are going to Mutale Mwanza and saying, please forgive Sarafina. Forgive Sarafina for what? What did Sarafina do? If she reported Sarafina to the police, it's no longer in her jurisdiction to forgive Sarafina. The matter must go to court. Don't just go and start saying rubbish. Forgive Sarafina, forgive Sarafina, forgive Sarafina, forgive Sarafina. No one is asking for forgiveness. What everyone is asking is justice for Sarafina. Let Sarafina be released and face Mutale Mwanza in the court. That's all. That's all. That's what everybody's crying for. No one is asking for who is she to forgive people? Who is she? What does he have to forgive people? Why must she be worshipped? Why must she control the police and tell police what to do? And when there is a president in Zambia? Eh? Why don't you release Sarafina to go and take care of her child that is dying there in the copper belt? Why are you so wicked? Eh? We are calling on the government of Zambia to release Sarafina with immediate effect. The case is between her and the Mutale Mwanza. Let them go to court and sort it out. Release the girl from the filthy prison. She's dying in the prison and everyone is quiet. What kind of thing is going on there?